Hello, this is Pastor Mike Wheaton, the senior pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church here in Pauls Valley, Oklahoma. And today I want to announce the release of The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God. And we'd like you to pick up a copy of this handy workbook with the new scan technology. So you can go through the book, The Secret to Your Best Life, learn God's plans, preparation, products, and path, and purpose for your life. And also, you can use the scan technology to go into a deeper understanding through watching videos and listening to MP3 file sermons to help bring out a better understanding while you're taking notes as well in The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook. So we want you to pick this up, and it will be available within major bookstores in about 6 weeks. It's already available now on Amazon.com, and we'd just love for you to pick up a copy as well as Kindle. So we'd love for you to pick up a copy of The Secret to Your Best Life, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God, the workbook edition with the new scan technology. I don't believe that this technology is being used to teach the Word of God anywhere else. So get this book and also pick up other books that I have available. The regular Secret to Your Best Life, just the regular book, as well as How to Choose a Worthy Mate. And if you're going to be a part of my class entitled The Effective Bible Reader, pick up that before you come to class on Amazon.com. So we want to thank you for listening. May God bless you and keep you is my prayer.
This morning is supposed to be Don't Neglect the Word from Acts chapter 6, verse 1 through 4. But God has led me to do something different this morning.
Right.
We're going to share a little hope for the holidays. And we want to remind you that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Amen.
That Jesus is the reason for the season. The word that we're going to share this morning is doing well, doing well. We're going to look at Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, verse 7 through 10. Galatians chapter 6, verse 7 through 10. Will you please stand in reverence to the word of God? Stand symbolically saying that I will stand on the word of God. This is the King James. It reads a little different, or it reads different from the NIV. Galatians 6, 7 through 10. Let's read it on three. One, two, three.
Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting. And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we not faint. As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them who are of household faith.
Amen. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. Again, we're sharing the message entitled Doing Well, Doing Well. From this, we're going to talk about equal justice, equal reward, and equal opportunity. Equal justice, equal reward, and equal opportunity. And we want Christians to know today that Christians should not be discouraged in doing well, because God is a God of justice.
Amen.
True. Christians should not be discouraged in doing well, because God is a God of justice. I want you to read the words on this brief video, and then we'll get into the word itself.
But we get up, oh yes, for a saint is just a sinner.
Galatians 6:9.
But we couldn't stay there. And God is saying now,
we fall down, oh, but we get up.
Undoubtedly, in our world today, seems to be a world that is turning upside down. Between what's happening in our culture in regards to a young man in New York that said, I can't breathe. Another man in Ferguson who had his hands held high. Our country is pretty much in a outrage.
Come on.
In Washington, D.C. this weekend, thousands from all over the country protest. And in New York City, there's been protests. And all across the country and across the world, there have been prayer vigils. And people are just outraged about what's happening in our culture.
Come on.
On top of that, there's mudslides in California.
Right, right.
Rains and floods. And on top of that, some within our family of faith are dealing with health issues.
Right.
Some, like the Prince family, lost a brother. Others, like Sister Erlene there in California, lost
a son.
And we are indeed in a perilous time.
Come on,
In perilous times, and when we began to go through so much, some will be tempted to give up hope.
Come on, come on, Doc.
And also, they tell us that during the holiday season, that it is a time when the suicide is at its highest peak.
Come on.
A time when many people are celebrating the holidays and putting up lights and trees and many beautiful decorations. There are some who, in their own minds, because of what they used to have, maybe because mama was used to be alive during this time and mama made the holiday.
Come on.
Maybe it was grandmama or that dear person that you love, and this is your first or your second or even your third year that you go into the holidays, and it seems like that it hits you so hard this time.
Help us.
Come on.
Oh, it seems like we're going through a perilous time. And it seems like that there is no hope, but God sent me all the way back from Nashville, Tennessee, back home to Paul's Valley to let you know that you are doing well. Say to your neighbor, neighbor, you're doing well. You're doing well, considering all the things that you're going through. You're doing well, considering, that you're carrying a lot of weight and a lot of heartache and a lot of pain. You're doing well, considering.
Thank you.
Hello, somebody.
Thank you.
You're doing well. Say to your neighbor again,
neighbor.
You're doing well.
You're doing well.
I had to talk to somebody that was in school and they had to be trained for a new job, and this is a very hard job, they're in school and in ministry and they are wondering whether they can make it through. And I just had to tell them, considering all that you're going through, you're doing well. Tell somebody, you may not be able to be an A student this semester, but as long as you make it through the class, you're doing well. Because of all that you're going through, and once again, God wants you to know that you're doing well.
Yeah, good work, man.
The first part of the text that we want to share about is we talk about equal justice, and we talked about some of the things that are going on in our country and in our world today, where it seems like that justice won't roll down like a mighty stream, and it seems like that justice is being overlooked in the street, and there's some Christian folk that are so upset and so mad that they want to throw away their Christianity and other voices in the wind out there blowing that are suggesting that there must be violence. And I'm here to tell you, to let you know as a Christian person, you don't have to lose faith. You don't have to lose hope. You don't have to get mad. You're going to go out and destroy things, because there is a court in the heavenlies. And that court in the heavenlies don't see race. That's why the court in the heavenlies don't see classes. That court in the heavenlies, justice will always prevail. For the text tells us this morning, do not be deceived. Christian, you don't have to get mad as a Christian. God says, for you today, do not be deceived. Some of you are deceived, and you're deceived, and you want to get upset. You want to get mad. Hello, somebody. You want to cuss somebody. You want to go out and fight somebody. You want to go out and destroy something. God says, do not be deceived. I'm not mocked. I don't care what position that he has. I don't care if he wears a badge. I don't care if he don't wear a badge. I don't care if they saw it on tape and it looked like he got away. God says, don't be deceived. God is not mocked. If the man sow it, he's going to reap it. Hello, somebody. Say to your neighbor. You're going to sow what you reap.
You're going to sow what you reap.
Hello, somebody. Now, that time they like to call that karma. No, that's not karma. That's God. Hello, somebody. God says, I can't be mocked. I see everything, and I have the power to do something about it. In Jesus' name. It may look like they got away with it in the dark. It may look like they got away with it in the light. But I am God, and you can't deceive me. Oh, you can deceive some folk. And they're thinking that somebody's guilty. And they're innocent. Hello, somebody. Or somebody's innocent. When they're guilty. But I am not like that. I am God. I cannot be deceived. I cannot be mocked. In Jesus' name. There's some folk that are concerned about the Cosby issue. Heard all the rumors about Cosby. And one of the things they like to say, to get Cosby off, is that there have not been any charges made against him. But that don't prove whether a man is guilty or not. Right. Because we saw somebody on the tape. And the other man died on the tape, and there were no charges brought. Well, hello, somebody. But I'm here to tell you that God knows. In the dark, God knows. In the light. And if man won't bring the charges, guess what? God will. Bring the charges, and I don't have to get upset and mad and cuss and be angry and ready to go out and do some stuff that God wouldn't want me to do. Hello, somebody, to lose my Christianity. I've heard Christian folk so upset that they're ready to lose their Christianity, and I have to tell them, you've got to get in the book. My God cannot be deceived. My God will not be mocked. My God is a God of justice. Hello, somebody. Give God a hand clap of praise. In his word, he said it twice in Deuteronomy 32, 35, and in Romans 12, 19, he says,
Do not take what revenge, my dear what friends, but leave what room for God's wrath. For what it says, for it is written, it is mine to avenge. And what? I will repay. He said, vengeance is mine, said the Lord. I will repay. Hello, somebody. And I don't care. Oh, if it's somebody, oh, here, and it's not the issues that are going on in our culture. Oh, you're at work. Oh, it seems like you're being looked over. It's like, oh, you're that person. You're doing your promotion. You're deceiving the one. The blows that gets to the is to do that's brown in the boss. See, they know how to be do nothing. All the person that's sleeping, knowing better, somebody's the one that starts and with the boss. Hello, somebody. Listen, I show you are the children of the sin, and God says, and if you regardless of you, your worship, oh, that you is being misused, abused, do not God see. God is not mock the Lord. Vengeance is mine, says I will repay.
Justice, but he gives equal reward. Hello, somebody. He says, and let us not be weary
in doing well and well doing.
Let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season
we shall reap if we faint not.
Hello, somebody. In times like these, people want to get weary and they want to throw in the towel because they don't believe that God can take care of it. In times like these, you've been faithful to your ministry, and it seems like people don't appreciate your ministry. People don't appreciate what you're doing at the job, and it seems like nobody sees you. And many times we get discouraged. But God says today, I'm going to give you equal reward for your service. You don't do anything for me. For not. I was in a meeting yesterday with our moderator, and the moderator said, and I heard Reverend Russian tell this same story about his grandfather and his grandpa. At the end of his life, God opened him. He said to him, to the moderator, Mac, but he explained the girl that goes him says, explain if he's in the world to the arts, that he's got the him a faith found at the end. He's going to give him a righteousness. Therefore, I said, found those and their fellows. Anybody said, God better come to me. And the nation, son, when you are faithful, and then it's the Lord. The fellows are faithful when you live to the holy, to the Lord. Son, you live right here when you son to him with all your heart. When it seems perfect, and a heart else, is doing my own thing. Everybody like that song that's there on the everybody else, I dance, everybody, all right, and it seems new. This world is gone, after that, but here you are, the world's good at two now, and then you're missed two, and it seems like you are, that you're good at this, and it seems like that you're not even thinking in it, as my God, some mess, today, don't you get away, today, I'll do something, we'll going to receive all call from the Almighty. Only all it belongs to your deity.
Yes.
Only
your soul.
The reason your faith was not if you faith on God, that means that you don't believe.
You don't believe. No faith.
The word says, oh, without faith, it's impossible to please God.
Yes.
And if you are being faith on God, oh, that means that you don't believe in God. Hello, somebody. And that's why God says today, oh, that you gotta believe. Hello, somebody. Regardless of what the doctors say, you got to believe. Oh, regardless of what's going on in your life, the storms may be raging. Oh, your loved ones may be passing on, but you got to faint not. Hello, somebody. Thank you, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor. You better faint not.
Better
in Jesus' name. For it says that if you don't faint, that there's a due season.
That's nice.
There's a due season. Oh, Reverend Rushing's grandpa, knew his due season was at the end of his life.
Yeah.
Some of us, that due season is in the middle of our life.
Yeah.
If we live on just a little longer, if we be faithful just a little bit more, you're closer than what you think. Say to your neighbor,
neighbor,
you're closer than you realize. Tell somebody, don't faint. Don't faint. Don't give up.
Yeah.
There's an equal reward in this thing.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. There's an equal reward in this thing. My God pays off. Hello, somebody. And that's why Psalms 126:5 says, those that sow with tears will what?
Reap with sounds of joy.
That means that when times get hard,
and
you keep being faithful, you keep sowing your seeds of righteousness. In hard times, when there's a heavy load on your back, and you don't give up, you keep being faithful, and you keep sowing your seed, and you don't give up. God says that if you don't give up, and you sow in tears, you can reap with songs of joy. Hello, somebody.
Neighbor,
if you want joy, don't give up. Hello, somebody. Say to the other neighbor,
neighbor,
if you want
joy,
you can't give up.
You
cannot give up. Look in your neighbor's eyes. I mean, look into their eyes. Try to look at their souls and tell them, don't give up.
Don't give up.
Amen. I know you're going through a lot. I know this is a hard season.
Come on back.
I know the devil is, in basketball terms, is putting you in a full court press. Hello, somebody. Anybody know about that full court press? Oh, some teams, at the end of the game, and it seemed like they're about to lose. The coach calls a full court press. And that which was easy now becomes hard. You could easily throw it in to your teammate. Now everybody is ticking. You can't do the easy stuff easy no more. Hello, somebody. Somebody's in here, and the devil has you in full court mode. You can't do the easy stuff no more. You can't sleep like you used to sleep. You can't walk like you used to walk. You can't talk like you used to talk. You can't spin like you used to spin. Your holidays can't be like they used to be. Mom and dad and them is gone. You can't afford to go home. You're in college and you're stuck on the campus and nobody's there and you feel lonely and alone. The devil has you in a full court press. That which was easy, oh, you can't do no more. It's hard. But God tells me that if you keep hustling, God tells me if you keep sowing, God tells me that if you keep on doing what you're supposed to do, that He's going to enable you to get rejoy.
Neighbor,
I need some of that joy.
I need some of that joy.
Hello, somebody. I need some of that joy. I've been going through a hard time. My body, like our deacon told us, about his sickle cell. Normally don't take this time. This much time to get back. And it's been a hard road for him. Hello, somebody, but he's kept sowing. In times of tears. He's been in pain. Could barely make it to the church, but he's teaching the word anyhow. And God has sent me here today to let those who know, that those who are going through a hard time, God says, that if you sow in tears, you'll reap with songs of joy. Church, you live a neighbor. I need that song. God says today that you're doing
well.
Tell somebody. That's good, though. Say to your neighbor.
Neighbor.
You're doing well.
You're doing well.
This is the way you get into the finish line, the equal opportunity. Hello, somebody. The devil is trying to stop your ministry. Hello, somebody. He's trying to stop you from going to church. Stop you from Wednesday. Stop you from coming to the youth meeting. Stop you from doing what you should do. But instead of giving up, as the text says in verse 9, God says it's time to raise your level in your ministry. For the text says, as we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto those who are the household of faith. Hello, somebody. The devil's trying to stop you from preaching, which means that you should preach yet all the still more. The devil's trying to stop your marriage, but you should love all the still more. The devil's trying to stop your finances, but you should give all the still more. Hello, somebody. The devil's trying to stop you, and you need to press through his full court press and go on down and score a basket for the kingdom. Say to your neighbor, if you're alive, you have opportunity. Therefore, our opportunity, let us do good. Hello, somebody.
Yes.
Say to your neighbor.
Neighbor.
It's time to do good.
It's time to do good.
Hello, somebody.
Yes.
During this holiday season, it's a wonderful time to let people know that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Yes, amen.
How about instead of buying all those gifts for yourself, why don't you find a family that is needy? Hello, somebody. And why don't you give them a gift? Hello, somebody. Instead of spending all your money on your holiday meal, how about you buy some sacks of groceries? Hello, somebody, and leave it. Groceries. That's what grandmama and them used to call it. And they were the ones that gave groceries away. Hello, somebody. We have groceries. We don't give it away. Hello, somebody. We stack it up. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. This is a wonderful time to do good, even though, you're going through a horrible time. You may be missing mama during this season. Maybe you need to find a mama that don't have a child, and you need to join in with him or her, mama and dad. Hello, somebody. Get a new mama and get a new daddy and give them gifts. Hello, somebody. Reach out to them. Hello, somebody. Maybe your kids won't come back home for the holidays, but there's some kids that don't have a mama or a daddy. Maybe you need to adopt. Hello, somebody. Somebody else's kids. loyalty. Hello, somebody. This is the season.
Yeah.
Oh, to take advantage of the opportunity and to do good. Hello, somebody. Say to your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Jesus is the reason for the season.
Jesus is the reason for the season.
Hello, somebody.
Yes.
And instead of hoarding up stuff for yourself, hello, somebody. Yep. Give something to somebody else.
All right.
Hello, somebody. Good word, that's what the text says. Therefore, opportunity, let us do good. And many times, it says, do good unto all men. Now, we can do good to all men.
Yeah.
But especially to them who are of the household of faith. Hello, somebody. Why give something to somebody out there that ain't living right and ain't doing right? Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
Why don't we find somebody in here to do something good for?
Man, yeah, man.
Yeah. Ooh, that's deep.
That's deep. That's what it said, Rick.
That's deep.
That's what it said.
Hello, somebody. Do something for somebody that's good in here.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Word.
And you know they're going through a hard time. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
Why don't you reach out?
Man.
Why don't you? But you say, preach up, they won't accept it. If they want to accept it, they ain't got to know you gave it.
Amen.
Put it on their doorstep and leave.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Hello, somebody. They ain't got to know.
Amen.
That's the problem with most of us. We want folk to know what we did.
Yeah. Right. Come on,
hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. And that's why they be up at these meetings and they call and say how much they gave, because people tend to give more when it's publicly.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Be heard and seen, right?
But they get their reward. That's their reward.
That's there. It. That's
but if you give it privately, God will reward you. Hello, somebody.
Man.
Well, you want to reap what you sow.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Get a book, man.
Hello, somebody.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Some of the greatest blessings I've ever received in my lifetime was when I was going through a hard time.
Yes.
And some grocers showed up.
You so crazy.
Maybe y'all ain't never been there. Y'all always had it good.
Yeah, yeah.
But I ain't always had it good.
Come on.
Hello, somebody. But God blessed me so much that I was eating better when I was going through a hard time. Hello, somebody. Because somebody bought some stuff that I wouldn't normally buy.
Come on.
Yeah.
And I knew it was from the Lord.
Yeah.
Some good stuff.
Man, somebody.
So even though I was going through a hard time, oh, God blessed me with some good stuff.
Thank you, Lord.
And that's a true blessing. And we need to give some good stuff away this holiday season.
Yeah.
Hello, somebody.
Yep.
And do it for somebody in here.
Mm-hmm. All right.
That's deep, isn't it?
That's in the word.
That's love. They'll know we are Christians by our love. By our love. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. That's where this St. Nicholas came from. He was supposed to have been a Christian. Hello, somebody. And he would give gifts away, and nobody would know who gave it.
That's right.
Hello, somebody. He gave in secret. That's somebody that truly had the gift of giving.
Right.
Hello, somebody. This holiday season, let's exercise that gift of giving.
Amen.
As we have, therefore, opportunity.
Opportunity.
Let us do good.
Do good.
Unto all men.
Oh.
Especially. Hello, somebody. Unto them who are what?
Household of faith.
Hello, somebody.
That's what it says.
Shall we pray? Deacons, will you come? Saints of praise.
Hello, this is Pastor Michael Eaton, the senior pastor of the Bethlehem Baptist Church here in Pauls Valley, Oklahoma. And today I want to announce the release of The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God. And we'd like you to pick up a copy of this handy workbook with the new scan technology, so you can go through the book, The Secrets of Your Best Life, Learn God's Plans, Preparation, Products, and Path, and Purpose for Your Life. And also, you can use the scan technology to go into a deeper understanding through watching videos and listening to MP3 file sermons to help bring out a better understanding while you're taking notes as well in The Secret to Your Best Life, the workbook. So we want you to pick this up, and they will be available within major bookstores in about 6 weeks. It's already available now on Amazon.com, and we'd just love for you to pick up a copy as well as Kindle. So we'd love for you to pick up a copy of The Secret to Your Best Life, Understanding the Will of God Through the Word of God, the workbook edition with the new scan technology. I don't believe that this technology is being used to teach the Word of God anywhere else. So get this book, and also pick up other books that I have available. The regular Secret to Your Best Life, just the regular book, as well as How to Choose a Worthy Mate. And if you're going to be a part of my class entitled The Effective Bible Reader, pick up that before you come to class on Amazon.com. So we want to thank you for listening. May God bless you and keep you is my prayer.